Hello, cheapskaters. I'm Kath Armstrong, creator of the Cheapskates Club, where our goal is to live life debt-free, cashed up, and laughing. Well, on Tuesday night, I promised to share my side hustles, my ideas for side hustles, easy ways to earn a little extra income this year. If you're crafty, then there are so many things you can do to earn some cash. One of the ways I'll be bringing in a little extra income this year is via my blog shop. Now, we've had it up for a few years and it's been a bit hit and miss because we don't really concentrate on it unless it's Christmas. This year, we're starting in January and we'll work on it all year round. I'll be making and selling handmade items like my knitted dishcloths and crocheted dish scrubbies, makeup removers, all sorts of things. The instructions for both of these are on the Cheapskates Club website, and I'll post the links below if you'd like to try making them for yourself. They're really, really easy and fantastic to use. I'm also going to add more hanging hand towels and hanging kitchen towels to our shop. These are things that I use in our kitchen and bathroom, laundry, and I love them. So I'm more than confident to put them into our shop. Then, of course, there are the greeting cards of all kinds for all occasions. Another way to bring in some cash, I have some lavender plants that I'm propagating. These are cuttings taken from my lavender bushes that I actually grew from cuttings from my mother-in-law's lavender patch. And I've tended them and given them lots of TLC, and they've grown like Topsy. So I will be propagating and selling my lavender plants. Another thing that I'm thinking of that could bring in a little extra cash are mini terrariums. We have some really pretty succulents in our garden, and they are really easy to propagate. And I have an idea in my head to make some cute little teeny tiny mini terrariums and put them in the shop. None of these alone will make us rich. And that's not why we have our blog shop. But for us, every cent counts and will make life easier. And I'm pretty sure it's the same for most of us, you included. Now, for the last few years, I've made and donated greeting cards around $2,500 to $3,000 a year. And I'd like to still be able to do this. That's one of my give back things that I like to do. Now, in the past, the cards that I've sold have paid for the materials to make more cards for the nursing homes. Because I didn't really have the cash in our budget to fork out for, you know, 3,000 cards a year. And I'm not planning on changing that, but I will also hopefully be selling a few more cards and then putting a little of that money aside for us. I'll still be doing cards for the nursing homes, and I work on those every week, but some of the money will be siphoned off to buy more supplies. Some will go into our savings for us. Now, since Christmas, my hands haven't been idle. If I'm sitting and I'm not working, I've had knitting needles or a crochet hook in my hands, and the results are more stock for the shop. So these are the side hustles that will fill my spare time this year. But what about you? What could you do to bring in a little extra cash? Now, I know you're just as busy as I am, and if you have babies or preschoolers or primary schoolers, small children or teenagers, then you are busier than I am. And I remember the days of thinking, it'll get easier when they're older. And suddenly they were older and it wasn't easier. I was busier than ever before. So I understand that you are busy, but do you garden? Could you propagate some plant cuttings and put them in some pots and sell them? Could you even grow some plants from seed? Now, seeds are inexpensive and pretty easy to start off. And I will put the link to my newspaper seed pots below. Then you won't even have to worry about pots for the seedlings. They're super simple to make and really easy. Think ahead if you're doing seeds and start seeds for the coming season. So here in Australia, autumn coming up. So start seeds now that will be ready to plant out in March, April, May. Do you have lemons or mandarins or oranges growing on your fruit trees? More than you can use? Sell them. Oh my goodness. Have you seen the price of lemons in the supermarkets? $2 each. And limes are $1.20 each. Ouch. But if your trees are prolific and you have enough lemon butter and enough frozen juice to last you for a year or so or until the next harvest, selling them will bring in some cash and those lemons won't be wasted. Same deal with your summer garden. Right now, gardens are producing reasonably well. Ours is going great guns, except for the tomatoes. So think about selling your excess produce, the tomatoes, the cucumbers, the zucchini, the eggplant, the bok choy, the silver beet, the herbs, whatever you're growing. Think about selling it. Now, if you're in the habit of giving that produce away, of sharing it, stop and think. The people you give it to really appreciate it, but they probably think that your sharing hasn't cost you anything. But it has. It has cost you something. You've had to pay for the seed or the seedlings. You've paid for the water, if nothing else. You've paid for the water and perhaps the fertilizer and mulch. And you've spent your time caring for those plants. You dug the gardens over, you planted them, you've looked after them each day, kept the weeds off, and then you've harvested them. So your produce is most definitely not free. So instead of giving it away, try selling it, at least to recover your costs, because that's reasonable. And if you can make a small profit, great. That's not being mean or stingy or greedy. It's being sensible. It's nice to be generous, but you can't afford to be out of pocket with your generosity. Perhaps you sow. Could you let friends, family, colleagues know that you're available to take up hems or sew on buttons or do basic repairs? Trust me when I say there is money to be made. Have you seen how much it costs to get a pair of pants shortened? I did some checking just this morning before I sat down to record this show, and it was jolly lucky I was sitting down. $15 to shorten a pair of jeans or trousers without cuffs, $25 if they have cuffs, and wait for it, because you need to be sitting down for this one. If they're skinny or slimline trousers, $35 to take them up, to do a simple hem, and to sew on a button, which takes no more than 5 minutes in total, costs $6 for one button. So if you're handy with a sewing machine and a needle and thread, there is money to be made. Just put the word out. Tell people that you are available to do those jobs for them. Now, along those lines, and this is a little bit odd, I was surprised, but there's also money to be made in finishing up UFOs. That just means that you take over a partially completed embroidery or cross stitch or quilt or dress or whatever and finish it. You just finish it. You just do the rest of it and charge accordingly. Speaking of quilts, a great way to use up your fabric stash and make some money is to make quilts, either complete quilts or quilt tops. Handmade soaps sell well. And if you are making and selling soaps with lye, then you need to be registered and licensed. Now, that's to cover you, because we all know lye is dangerous. But the license to be able to sell soap isn't too expensive. And yes, if you're going to sell them, it's considered a business and you need to be licensed. You also need to be registered for GST. But if you make melt and pour soaps, you don't need to be licensed. There's no lye in melt and pour soaps. They're easy to do, they're quick, they're pretty, you've got lots of options, but the actual soap base is quite expensive. So the end product could be expensive, could be too expensive to sell. You can find all the details that you need online. And if you're going to be selling your soaps, it really is worth being licensed and insured. Now, another way to bring in some cash is selling your jams and pickles or your baking. Now, again, you need to be registered and licensed and insured. You do not want someone to sue you if they decide it was your apricot jam that made them sick. It's just not worth it. And, you know, check your local council for the requirements. They will have them, what you need to do to get your kitchen registered, and then away you can go. Ironing, not my favourite chore, but it pays well. And you can sit down and watch cheapskates shows while you do a basket or two. Dog walking, car detailing, pamphlet deliveries. Get your exercise for free or get paid while you exercise. Now, pamphlet deliveries don't pay really well, but again, every cent counts. Don't be precious about the money. Every cent counts. Do online surveys. Now, they can be a bit hit and miss depending on the demographic that they dump you in. But again, they don't take too long and they don't cost you anything. There's no materials or anything you have to do. And if you're sitting watching TV or, you know, listening to a podcast or something, filling out a survey online isn't too arduous, especially if you get paid for it. Do you take beautiful photos? Can you turn those photos into art and sell it? Can you turn them into photo books or scrapbooks? Can you charge for creating a digital or even a paper scrapbook for someone, a memory book? You could turn your scrapbooking hobby into a small business. Now, if none of those things interest you, what about selling? There's a market out there for recycled jars. I know there is, because I'm selling my jars that I'm not needing. If you don't recycle your jars and use them yourself, clean them up and sell them. Ditto the glass cordial bottles. Sell off the stuff that you don't use or want. Now, these are one-off boosts to your income, but every cent counts, and you're decluttering at the same time and stopping stuff going to landfill, being wasted. Resources are precious too, so we need to think about that. But, you know, I found Marketplace really easy to sell on, and I will use it again happily. Now, I prefer doing that to a garage sale, but if you're so inclined, go right ahead. Garage sales are a lot of work and they can be hit and miss in terms of a money-making venture. But if you have enough staff, you have the time, you're not going to be doing anything one Sunday morning, try a garage sale. ditto markets, you know, trash and treasure markets, craft markets and things like that. Although if you are a crafter, doing some of those markets around Mother's Day and again in the lead up to Christmas could be quite lucrative. Check out your local schools to see if they have fetes or fairs coming up this year, and if they are selling stalls or renting tables. And if they are, and it's not terribly expensive, you might be able to do a couple of those and bring in some extra money selling off your handiwork. Just be aware that you might not sell anything, or you might sell only a few things that won't even cover the cost of the table or the stall. But it's a learning experience, and you find out that you have a huge market at your fingertips. I have a friend who does her community market in December in the lead up to Christmas, and again for a couple of weeks before Mother's Day, and she sells her cards. The rest of the year, she's just busy making cards and creating stock for her stalls. Now, again, you're not going to get rich, but you'll get a little extra cash that should pay for replacing the materials, and you might have enough to keep something for yourself. You'll definitely be keeping things out of the recycle bin or landfill. If you're very talented, you could make and sell sets of pantry labels or name labels or clothing labels, things like that. You don't need a lot of fancy equipment to do that either. Now, someone's bound to ask, where will you find the customers? Do you have family? Do you have friends? Do you have neighbours? Do you have colleagues? Do you have kids at daycare or school? Do you play sport? Or do you have a spouse or partner or kid who plays sport? Church friends? What about any clubs you belong to? Do you have a blog or a social media following? There's your market. There's your customers. They are your sources for potential sales. Put the word out that you are selling lavender plants or home-baked bread or apricot and almond jam or photos, photo albums or whatever. See what happens. Add photos to your own personal Facebook posts of what you've got to sell and see what the reaction is. I have a friend who is an absolute whiz at organising, and last year during the pandemic, when she was on lockdown and not actually able to work, she started selling her time to help her friends organise their pantries. She's really good at it, and by word of mouth, she has booked up until mid-March this year. Now, she's doing something she loves. She really loves it. And she's helping others at the same time. And she's earning a bit of money for sharing her skill and her knowledge. So do you have a skill that you could teach to others? Perhaps you do beautiful embroidery, or you're an amazing potter, or you make incredible bread or delicious cheeses. Perhaps you have brilliant sewing machine skills. Selling your knowledge via classes, whether a group or private, is another way to bring in some extra money. And it can be quite lucrative. Have you seen the price of some of those things? Art lessons, if you're an artist, sewing lessons, anything like that, very expensive. If you don't believe me, check out the cost of a course of basic sewing lessons online. If you like driving and you have a reliable car, could you be a delivery driver? That, you know, again, might not be a huge moneymaker, but every cent counts. You choose the hours you work, whether it's after work, before work, weekends, public holidays, whatever. And you choose when you want to work. And you get paid to deliver food or groceries. There are lots of things that could become a lucrative. (Clears throat) there are lots of things that could become a lucrative side hustle and bring in a few extra dollars doing what you'd normally be doing anyway. If you need some extra cash, and who doesn't? Who wouldn't want it even if they didn't think they needed it? Think about some side hustles that would fit into your lifestyle. You may get a tsunami of customers, or you may get a trickle. The secret is to keep going. Stick at it. Don't give up after your first knockback or no sale or whatever. Stick to it. It will pay off in the end. Now, I'm going to take some photos of what I've finished doing the last couple of weeks and get some stock into our blog shop. Thank you so much for watching. If you like our channel, could I ask you to please click the thumbs up below me? And if you're not already subscribed, hit that subscribe button and then the little bell icon next to it. And then you'll be notified every time we do a live show or upload a video and you won't miss out. Thank you again for joining us. And goodbye till next time.